Hi there.
In today's video, we're going to learn how to convert an image into a cartoon image in Photoshop. So let's get started. I have this image opened in Photoshop, and the first thing I'm going to do is to right-click the image background layer and select duplicate layer to make a copy of this image. Let's rename our copy to photocopy and hit OK. The next step will be to convert this copy into a smart object. Converting it to a smart object will preserve the source content with all its original characteristics, enabling you to perform non-destructive editing to the layer, which is why we are doing it. Now, let's go to Filter and then Filter Gallery. We need to go to the Sketch folder, which will have quite a few options from which we need to select Photocopy. You may have guessed why we kept the name of the layer Photocopy. To view the entire image on the view window, go to the taskbar at the bottom left corner and change the viewing option to fit in view. And you shall find the image readjusting itself to fit into the screen on the left. Next, we need to adjust the detail and darkness options on the right. And the settings here depend entirely on the kind of image you have or the kind of look you want for your image. For this image, I'm going with 3 for detail and 50 for darkness. And hit OK. Next, we need to layer another similar setup to add the darker edges. So right click the background layer and make another duplicate layer and call it torn edges. You can understand from the name that this setting will be all about edges. Drag this layer to the top and then right click and convert it to smart object. Go to filter and then filter gallery and select the torn edges option that sits under sketch folder. You can find how it adds the darker shadows to the image. Much like earlier, the settings that you see here will depend upon the kind of image you have or the kind of look you want. I'm going to go with 18 for image balance, 15 for smoothness, and 14 for contrast, and hit OK. To blend the settings of this layer with the earlier one, update the blending mode to multiply, and Bob's your uncle. I think we need to lower the shadows a bit, so let's double click the filter gallery of this layer, and let's reduce the image balance to 12, and hit OK. The reason I did it is because I didn't want my image to have such dark shadows, but that does not mean you have to do it as well. Like I mentioned earlier, these settings are entirely based on the kind of image you have or the kind of look you want for your image. Time to make another layer, so right click the background layer and make another copy and rename it cutout. Now drag it to the top, go to image and then adjustments and select Desaturate. Your image should now be converted to a black and white image. Once the image is black and white, let's right click the layer and convert it to smart object. Let's now go to filter and then filter gallery. And this time let's go to the artistic folder and you will find the cutout option sitting there. So select it. Let's also change the view to fit in view option from the taskbar. I'll select 7 for the number of layers, in which case Photoshop will contour each color and then calculate the contour area for all colors one by one. For edge simplicity, I'll enter 3, and for edge fidelity, 3 again. Edge simplicity refines the edges as per the settings, and edge fidelity controls the threshold of the edge simplicity. Once the settings are done, let's hit OK. Let's blend the settings of this layer with the other two layers we created earlier. And to do that, let's change the blending mode to multiply. With the cutout layer still selected, let's lower the opacity to 30%. At this point, you can see how the image is transforming slowly and gradually with each settings. So now that we have the structure of our cartoon image almost ready, let's go to filter and then blur. And select Gaussian blur. Let's pick a radius of around 10 pixels and hit OK. We're doing this to subdue the harshness of the edges. Now it's time to add colors to this image. So let's start with the lips. I'm going to go to the adjustment option at the bottom of the layers panel and select solid color. From here, pick a pinkish tone, good enough for the lips, and the head of K. Now change the blending mode to multiply. Let's right-click this layer and go to blending options. In the layer style pop-up window, move the white slider to the left to see how the pink tone of this layer gets gradually removed from the areas in the image. Now hold Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC and click the slider, which will split it into two. And now you can fine-tune your settings. At any point, don't change the settings to the point that the color is completely removed from the area you actually want it in. And in our case, it is the lips. Select the white thumbnail of this layer and then go to Image and then Adjustments and select Invert, which will remove the pink tone you added, but will also turn the white thumbnail into black, like a mask. So now select the brush tool and ensure that you have the soft brush selected. Let's zoom into the lips and ensure that the foreground is white and then start painting the lips slowly and carefully. Once the lips are painted, let's add another color for skin. So let's go to the adjustment option and select solid color and then pick a skin tone of your choice and then hit OK. Let's change the blending mode to multiply to blend it with the rest of the layers. Now select the white thumbnail of this layer and go to image and then adjustments and select invert. The brush must already be selected, so just start painting the skin using a big sized brush. You can increase the size of the brush using the right bracket, and to reduce its size, hit the left bracket. While I'm painting the skin, at this point, I won't bother about the eyes or the stud she's wearing because I can fix that very easily. Once I've covered the majority of the sections for edges, I'd zoom in and also reduce the brush size and cover the areas not covered earlier. When the skin is painted completely, all I need to do is switch foreground color with the background color and then change it to black from the color picker option and hit OK. Now, with the black as my foreground color, when I paint, it will remove the skin color. So let's remove the color from both the eyes and any edges that need to be fixed. I'll fix it with the black brush. And lastly, remove the color from the stud. And the skin color is ready. To make the color pop a little, let's go to adjustments and then hue and saturation and play with the hue and saturation to enhance the colors a bit. Now we need to add one final color for her eyes. So let's go to adjustment options once again and select solid color. And from the color picker, pick a shade of your choice. I'm going to pick a shade of blue and hit OK. To blend this color with the rest of the layers, change the blending mode to multiply. For this one, I don't really need to go to the blending options and make changes to the underlying layer, as it is not really necessary since the area of the eyes is relatively smaller. So let's select the white thumbnail of this layer and go to image and then adjustments and select invert. Now zoom into the eyes and paint the eyes blue. Once the painting is over, it's time to put all these layers together as one. And for that, let's hit Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac or Control-Shift-Alt-E on a PC, and you shall find another layer being created. Let's click it and rename it Stamp or any other name that brings a smile to your face. Let's right-click this layer and convert it to Smart Object. Lastly, let's go to Filter and then Filter Gallery and select Cutout from the Artistic folder. Make necessary adjustments to the settings on the right. I'm going with 8 for number of levels, 5 for edge simplicity, and 3 for edge fidelity before hitting OK. To enhance the color of the image further, let's go to Adjustments option at the bottom of the Layers panel and select Color Lookup. From the 3D LUT file option, pick a color mode that suits you. I'm going to go with Crisp Warm Look. Let's also update the blending mode of this layer to Soft Light. And finally, to get rid of the spots on her face and around, Let's create another blank layer by hitting the small plus button at the bottom of the layers panel. Rename the layer Spot Remover, or you can just let it stay as it is. Now pick the Spot Healing Brush tool and ensure that Sample All Layers option is checked. Now click the spots to remove them one by one. So that's the original image, and that's the cartoon image you've just created. All right, guys, that concludes our session. Hope you've enjoyed it and have learned something new from it. So do like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Until we meet again, goodbye, and thanks for watching.